Hi everybody, and today I wanna take you on a little journey which has nothing to do with programming at all or technology. I decided to make a little screencast about just coding freaks and how I just make my screencasts and what technology I use, and I want to share with you my way to the things I use now and what happened and what went wrong and things like that. If you're not interested, it's totally okay. And I just want to share some more personal stuff with you if you like to. So I call it behind the scenes, and I will start up by showing you the place where all this stuff happens. So here you can see where I'm recording my stuff. You see it's 100% professional setup. You can see there my main monitors. I'm using 24-inch, and I'm just spanning all my desktop on every three of them. And my Visual Studio has all windows on those normally. And on the right side, you can see the notebook, which I'm using when I go to customers. And as you can see, there's no Coding Freaks logo on the desktop, because I'm working for a very, very young company now, which is called DevDeer. And we are at the beginning, kind of startup, and we are making a lot of cloud stuff right now, and especially in for Microsoft Azure and service-oriented applications, stuff like that. We're about 10 people. And some of those guys are members of Coding Freaks too. You know some of them maybe. Gunnar is making or made some casts too, and Tino is one of them, and a lot of other people. And yeah, that's where I sit. So the trigger for this little unordinary screencast was this mic, which you can see there, which is very, very mighty. And normally it's behind this first screen on the right. And it came to this because, well, first of all, I have to tell you, I'm from Germany. We're sitting in Germany, in the center of Germany, a city called Magdeburg. And this is why I have this unhearable accent a little bit. I have to say that normally, you know, this is my MVA, I call it MVA, the most valuable asset in all this setup here, my coffee. And it's standing right at the same place because I took this photo like 10 minutes ago. And then I have to say that normally this table is not in this, you know, condition. It's more like this trash can here. This is more like my table looks normally. So wanna be honest. Now, what happened in a few days ago was I created my screencast like I do it all the time, and I used this one to create my sound, which was cool. I thought it was cool because this tiny guy was straight in front of my mouth. That wasn't so cool for guys who are listening to me, which in fact led to this post from Travis Owens. Thank you, Travis, if you're seeing this. You triggered me to buy me something else. And he just sent me a link, and I didn't bought this one. I just bought this one. It's called a T-Bone SC, I don't know, you can see it by your own. And it's not that cheap, it's an USB mic. And I just use it now for my recordings. And I, as you saw it right there, it has a pop killer too, and it's a mighty setup, and it looks like I know what I do, what is not the case, in fact. What I want to show you now, if you are somebody who wants to make webcasts too, and who is asking yourself, how do I do it? And how do I post it to YouTube? I want to try to share something, that's it, with PowerPoint. I want to share something about this with you. And now you can see my desktop. And first of all, I will bring in the tool which is responsible for recording here. You can see it, it's called Camtasia Recorder. This is the Camtasia Recorder. I just show you the German on this one. This is a help. Info's about. This is Camtasia Studio. It's a cool tool. I can set up everything. I can just make it louder and more. And I can produce videos afterwards. I will show you this too. And sometimes I pause it and stuff like that. And when I'm finished, it looks kind of, just let me show you what it produces so you can see it. These are my pictures. It's not a good idea to share it with all the world, but anyways. I just have here all my videos, and I did lately a screencast called MVVM Lite. And this is what Camtasia creates. It creates T-Rec files, and you can open them in a second tool, which is part of the license. It's called Camtasia Studio. Let's see if I can adjust it a little bit to the screen. And here you can do a little bit of offering. You can put it in a timeline and do effects on it. And I can right click it and edit my audio and just remove noises and stuff like that. And I'm doing it right now. So this is, just let me circle my mic a little bit. So now it's adjusted right. Okay, this is a tool I use. And normally when I finished it, I produce this video, which takes for 10 minutes. It takes 10 minutes of video. It takes like 5 minutes of production. Which means I'm sitting here and waiting for the progress bar to finish. Afterwards, I create my own thumbnail image for YouTube. This is this one. Just show it to you, just a second. This is my thumbnail for this tutorial, which I mentioned. It's created by PowerPoint, I know, cool. Because PowerPoint has the ability to just export it in the right dimensions. I need the correct dimensions. And I can edit the text without using Photoshop or things like that. I just wanted to use a simple tool. So that is this. And now when we take a look at another tool, I'm now writing all my my posts on Coding Freaks when I'm doing my written stuff. It's done in normally it's done in this tool. It's called about how it is, where it is. Harupad is simply an editor where I can type Markdown, which I like because it's just unnerving to type in the WordPress editor. I will come to this point. And I write in Markdown and it creates this nice output. And then when I'm finished, just want to show you, I go to WordPress. This is my WordPress admin area. And I go here and just insert this Markdown here as it is into my WordPress. And this will lead to this kind of articles. That's what I do. And for bringing this to work, just if you're interested in, you need to use a plugin in WordPress. And this plugin is, where it is? Header, footer, jetpack, kinds of stuff, memory bump, very useful, syntax highlighter, typekit, there it is, WP Markdown Syntax Highlighter. I need this because in some places, I show you this one, I have source code, here you can see source code, and I need to give a hint to WordPress that this will be something which is shown with another plugin, which is called Syntax Highlighter Evolved. And so I need this other plugin, this one, WP Markdown Syntax, so that these parts are created correctly. That's what I do. Okay, why do I write in German? I don't know exactly, mainly because I can write faster in German. Second part is, I think most of you guys can translate with web technologies into English stuff. And it's just, you know, you see it, my articles are very long, and I just thought about making articles in English and German too. But my motto on codingfreaks.de on my webpage was to create a, as I think, high quality blog in German, because it's very rare. English guys have MSDN and stuff like that, and there are a lot of German guys which are not able to read concentrated in English, and I wanted to give them an ability to read in more detail. And then I recognized that when I made my videos in German, I recognized that my hits weren't so high. So now I want to share with you my hits so you can see what I see. You see here my YouTube account, and I just make it public here, and you can see there are videos here down on the second page, and here are my videos, and you see I have my oldest videos from 2011, and it's in German, and I reached not so much people. And here are 302 and 211, which is normal, because you know, Germany is not the biggest country on earth, and programmers are not the biggest part of the population. So naturally, it's not that you know, spreading. And now it comes to the newer ones, which are here. You can see them here. The studio, for instance, it's not that old, and it reached already 600 people. And there are another one which I'm very proud of, is this one, ASP.NET Identity 2.0, and it reached a lot of people. And here you can see the first part of this one reached 30,000 people, and I'm very proud of this. And you know, the thumbs up are more than the thumbs down. That's okay. I don't know exactly why somebody would give me some down, but anyway, it's okay. So I like this. And here I see, by the way, there's something wrong, and this, I will take this as an opportunity to show you how I edit it. And here you can see, okay, you have YouTube, and if you don't know it, you can, for example, define an user-defined thumbnail. It's in German here, but you can say, hey, take this JPEG instead of this stupid one, and use this one as the thumbnail. And when I then go back to this screen and refresh this, it should, hopefully, no. Sometimes it's a little bit unnerving. Let's see if it's again the case. So YouTube has some sort of bug there, I think. I don't know what I have to do to make this one. So now, user defined again, this JPEG. Let's see if I can bring him and save it. Maybe it takes a while. So that's what I do. So normally for one screencast of this length here, I need like 1.5 hours. It's 31 minutes. I need 1.5 hours for this. I try to make all this stuff in one step, but sometimes I have to pause, as I told you, and just bring it online then. So this is this. I have now, from the stats, I have a lot of articles. Let's take a look at my articles. I don't know exactly how much, where it is. 167 articles. 171 in some, and 167 from me. That's a stat. And 6 are in draft mode. So I don't know where they're in draft mode, somewhere there. And I have another one, which is another interesting thing, but it's just interesting for German guys. I just have a thing which is a fun part of codingfreaks.de. I just show it to you. Let's see, codingfreaks.de. This is a page as it is. And I have here something which is called, CSV rules, which is irony. Oh, somebody told me that my videos should be part 2. Yeah, he's right. I just messed it up. This one is part 2. He's so right. there it is. So I just wanted you to show this part here. You see, coding freaks, these are categories, and here is CSphere rules. And I just started to do something like a little book. I don't know. These are very long articles, and they are strictly just German. So if you can read German, you should definitely read this, because I think it's funny. And this is a kind of commercial for myself. So it's my blog, I can do it. Another thing which I just introduced not so long ago is that I created NuGet packages by my own. If you don't know it already, I just show it to you, because we are on GitHub too. So this is our GitHub repository, and we created this project here, CFUtils, and it has a lot of libraries inside. We use these libraries in our production code, so it has bugs, it has something like, we had some pull requests already, or one pull request, to be honest. And I'm very excited about this, because we use GitHub to show to our customers and to you guys that we are trying to contribute something to the community, and not to sit on it. And so we're using this stuff, and it's kind of nice, I think. So this is what we are doing when we're doing nonprofit stuff. And I just wanted to share this with you. I'm interested in comments and in questions. If you are interested in something more, just tell me. And yeah, nice to see you, and to see you back. Bye.